So now that we're in Vegas, we've got some pretty big news.
When we were about to make the announcement, there was huge red flags in my stomach. And I was like, I don't know how people are gonna react. I don't know how the kids are gonna react. I was nervous.
Guess what? In 7.5 months, Truly won't be the little one.
Couple of the teenagers didn't say a thing. Okay. They wouldn't even look at me. They were sort of just sitting there like this. And I was like, oh, shoot. It stung a little bit because I wasn't really sure at the time, you know, what to think.
I think teenagers, especially when you're in a big family, are like, Mom and Dad, we got enough, all right? We got enough.
There's so many voices that were not happy or struggling to accept Solomon, even after he was born. Like, I've done a lot to forgive reactions.
There was some weird attitudes when Robyn was pregnant with Solomon.
Robyn told me just 2 days ago that she was pregnant, and she wants to announce to everybody tonight that she's expecting.
I am really preparing myself for another experience that I had when Solomon was, you know, announced.
I actually wanted you all to come over here because I have a little announcement to make.
I know that every time Mary would find out about one of the other wives being pregnant, it was like a challenge for her. And I wanted her to feel involved.
Robyn's pregnant.
When everybody just cheered and was excited and happy, I was like, oh, phew.
Congratulations, sweeties.
It was the most unified, like, expression of excitement and happiness than we've had in a long, long time from the kids. It was really cool. Everybody's, like, excited. They want to name the baby.
I named my baby sister child.
Yeah, big reaction this time.
Great reaction.
Yeah, that first couple of years in Las Vegas before we got into the cul-de-sac was a little bit of a fog. It was hard on our family, those first 2 years. But those attitudes were very different once we were in the houses in Las Vegas, the cul-de-sac. So it was a much better experience altogether. We're in the Yucatan Peninsula, and she's making fun of me sweating.
Funny.
Come on, let's go.
Wait.
There's a lot that I love about Mary. I didn't know that I loved her because of her adventure level.
Are you realizing that now?
Yeah, it's kind of fun.
You know, looking at the things that he was saying about me, like, I didn't know that I was in love with you for this reason, or, you know, I love you for this reason. It's like, yeah, you did. Remember that you did.
I can see a long future of us doing things like this. This is cool.
Yeah, I just imagine the kids.
Wouldn't they just be like,
you'd never exhaust it.
But I honestly can say I'm more in love with you now than I ever was at the beginning.
I am in love with you more now.
If I just see our relationship continuing to be very involved with each other. And I see that until we die.
Kody and I always were very good friends. So we had a lot of discussion, a lot of companionship. I mean, really, truly. The longer you're together, the more you love each other. And it's a different way. It grows. It changes. But it's very much a deeper love than when you first were married. I mean, at this point, I didn't perceive that changing. Kody and I's strongest foundation was that we were friends. I mean, really, truly, we were very good friends.
It's mine and Kody, a very cheap therapy session for both of us. Just being able to shoot each other, I think it ought to go down as one of the rules to a good marriage.
Holy cow, you're covered in paint. In fact, I felt bad for shooting you.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yeah.
I just felt bad I lost.
Christine and my relationship in the past has been very well established on the lightness of life, just the pleasure of just being alive and being together. So we have had a couple years of struggle, but we've been able to find that place once in a while here, and here we found it again.
Okay, on this date that Christine and I are on here, we're acknowledging the struggle we're having, and we had one good day. So we're talking about, oh, now it's better, you know, we had this one good day. When you are together, even if it's not good, you do your best, you're optimistic, you try to work things out in the relationship.
Some downs were really low and some ups were really high. And that wasn't a high, that was definitely a high, that was great. We probably were getting along for a couple weeks there.
Perfect date.
Perfect date.
Perfect like many more yet to come.
Like many more yet to come.
I'm sorry, honey. It's been a rough year.
No, it's been a rough year for everybody.
Okay.
We'll work it out.
I know. You see right there? It seems like he loved me there. I just remember him loving me. So I was super shocked when he said he didn't anymore. You know, I'm just saying.
So what was real? You know, because he's now saying these things like, no, I was just performing. It wasn't really how I felt, you know? And it's like, really, you're that good of an actor? Because, like, I don't think that those scenes were, and those moments, I don't think that you're lying.
I remember how I felt here in those scenes, and yet I was still being optimistic about our lives. It was a struggle. And next year, if we were still together next year, it'd be the same struggle.
You ready to look at some more clips?
Yes. I do not know iPads. Well, I just turned the camera on.
So swipe up from the bottom. You're not swiping correctly. You gotta go from that line. See that line at the bottom?
Oh.
You literally weren't like, I was just trying to get under your skin, but you weren't swiping correctly.
That's funny, okay.
I'm just wanting to know, here we are 2 years later, and we were back to having seen some doctors, and we're talking in vitro fertilization. So what are your thoughts?
It just freaks me out to go through all of that again. Mm-hmm. I want to have another baby. I would love that. But I don't want to deal with everything leading up to the possibility of maybe I might be able to.
Is the things that you don't do that you regret more than the mistakes you make? When we're 60 years old, or we're dying when we're 110, we'll look back and darn, we'll be glad we had done the in vitro fertilization.
You asked me one time, yes or no, are you gonna do it or are you gonna not? Mm-hmm. So I guess I'm asking you, yes or no. Do you want to have another baby with me or do you not?
I would do it if nature just did it. If God just, right. It was just happened. No problem. In fact, absolute, positive, just it would just be absolutely wonderful. But because of the stakes, I'm not burning in my gut to do it. You know what I'm saying? I say no.
Kody and I were kind of in a slightly tumultuous time in our marriage. I remember I was planning on telling him that day that I was wanting to move forward with in vitro. You know, it took Kody and I 5 years to have Leon. After that, I did a lot of medical, naturopathic, you know, lots of things just to try to figure out how to have another baby, because I really wanted to have more than just one.
From the time that we were in Mexico to a year later when we're in Las Vegas talking, sort of wrapping this idea up, I was very gung-ho about it, about trying to have another baby 1 year earlier. During that time, I think it was just more realization that our marriage is not really healthy.